Hi, it's Kurt again from Shopping Actions. In part one of setting up data attributes, we learned how to implement required attributes. In this video, I'll show you how to add some recommended attributes that can help your product stand out. I'll also give you some optimization tips at the end, so stick around. Let's jump to the demo. First, log into your Merchant Center account. Click Products, then Feeds. After the feed page opens, select the feed you'd like to edit by clicking Open. We already have our required attributes populated here for our black Google tea. Let's add a few recommended attributes. Let's add the value 100 to sell on Google quantity to restrict the number of items sold on Shopping Actions. This will prevent Google from selling more than 100 t-shirts. Let's now add a Google product category to help customers find our product. If you don't provide a category, Google will assign a relevant one to your offer. This feed is also serving our Shopping Ads campaign. Let's say we don't want to sell this item on Shopping Actions. We can add the Shopping Actions value in the Excluded Destination field. This will prevent this item from being sold on Shopping Actions. We'll add a link to our site. It will help Google match the attributes on our site with the data on our feed. Make sure the link is valid and crawlable. And finally, let's fill in the sale price to tell users that we are reducing the price to $10 during a sale and add sale price effective date to tell Google how long we want the sale price to be shown to users. Now, let's go back to Merchant Center to submit our feed. Click Fetch Now. Don't forget to review the Diagnostic tab to see if any errors need to be fixed. Before you go, here are three tips to help you optimize your feed. Number one, set up feed rules in Merchant Center to align your product data with Shopping Actions requirements. Feed rules helps you transform an existing file into a working feed without manually editing the file. Number two, set up a fetch schedule in Merchant Center so that the data in your feed is refreshed at the same time as the data in your website. Your data must be refreshed at least once every 30 days to avoid product disapproval. Number three, tax, shipping, and return attributes are configured directly in Merchant Center. You can also configure those attributes at the feed level, which will override the Merchant Center attributes. And that's it. Keep in mind that we've only covered a few recommended attributes. There are more than 60 that can help your product stand out. Thanks for watching. Check out the links in the description to learn more in our Help Center.